On this side, Hari, Big Basket has entered Bombay, and you also entered the hearts of many families in Bombay. Okay, I can see on Twitter, people are enjoying the Big Basket experience. So what are you discovering in the last, is it last year and a half of Big Basket?
Yeah, thanks, Rajiv. Actually, the category we are in is a very, very simple to, you know, gauge who the customer is. It's primarily the lady, in the house. And, you know, standard stuff like, you know, a lady, husband, you know, dual working, don't have enough time to actually get to stores and stuff like that. So, but what's more important, and that's that we've discovered, is that very often, while it's a lady who's the end consumer, the email ID and the phone numbers is the husband's. So it's a tricky, complex, you know, situation to handle that. So essentially, it's a family that, you know, at home that, you know, that caters. The important thing and the last and only point that I want to make is what we find different with regard to the consumer is that this lady who's online is far, far more demanding. And the people in the grocery business here would understand this term called fill rates. I mean, we use it very, very often. That's because we've got 30, 40, 50 products typically in a basket of a consumer. And these people expect 100% fill rate because the reason that they come online is that they don't want to go to a store. So they keep coming back and telling you that, you know, even if I have to go for one or two items, I'd rather go to a store and do the rest. And that's a huge challenge, you know, that we online, you know, grocery people face in terms of, you know, consumer expectations.